नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। प्रिजर्विंग टेक्स्ट 30-35 ऑफ चैप्टर 1, ऑब्जर्विंग द आर्मीज ऑन द बैटलफील्ड ऑफ कुरुक्षेत्र ऑफ श्रीमद् भगवद गीता। टेक्स्ट 30-35। किमनो राज्येन गोविंद किम भोगेर जीवितेन वा येषामर्थे कांकक्षितं नो राज्यं भोगाव सुखानि च त इमे अवस्थिता युद्धे प्राणां स्तय यक्तवा धनानि च आचायाः पितरः पुत्रास्तथैव च पितामहाः मातुलाः श्रवशुराः पौत्राः शालाः संबंधिनास तथा एतानन हन्तु मिच्छामि घनतो अपि मधुसूदन अपि त्रैलोक्य राजस्य हे तोह किमनु महि कृते निहत्य धार्तराष्ट्रानः का प्रीतिः स्याज जनार्दन। ओ गोविंद, of what avail to us are a kingdom, happiness, or even life itself, when all those for whom we may desire them are now arrayed on this battlefield? O Madhusudan, when teachers, fathers, sons, grandfathers, maternal uncles, fathers-in-law, grandsons, brothers-in-law, and all relatives are ready to give up their lives and properties and are standing before me, why should I wish to kill them, even though they might otherwise kill me? O maintainer of all living entities, I am not prepared to fight with them, even in exchange for the three worlds, let alone this earth. What pleasure will we derive from killing the sons of Dhritarashtra? Arjun has addressed Lord Krishna as Govind because Krishna is the object of all pleasures for cows and the senses by using this significant word. Arjun indicates that Krishna should understand what will satisfy Arjun's senses. But Govind is not meant for satisfying our senses. If we try to satisfy the senses of Govind, however, then automatically our own senses are satisfied. Materially, everyone wants to satisfy his senses, and he wants God to be the order supplier for such satisfaction. The Lord will satisfy the senses of the living entities as much as they deserve, but not to the extent that they may covet. But when one takes the opposite way, namely, when one tries to satisfy the senses of Govind without desiring to satisfy one's own senses, then by the grace of Govind, all desires of the living entity are satisfied. Arjun's deep affection for community and family members is exhibited partly here due to his natural compassion for them. He is therefore not prepared to fight. Everyone wants to show his opulence to friends and relatives, but Arjun fears that all his relatives and friends will be killed on the battlefield and he will be unable to show his opulence after victory. This is a typical calculation of material life. The transcendental life, however, is different. Since a devotee wants to satisfy the desires of the Lord, he can, Lord willing, accept all kinds of opulence for the service of the Lord, and if the Lord is not willing, he should not accept a farthing. Arjun did not want to kill his relatives, and if there were any need to kill them, he desired that Krishna kill them personally. At this point, he did not know that Krishna had already killed them before their coming into the battlefield and that he was only to become an instrument for Krishna. This fact is disclosed in following chapters. As a natural devotee of the Lord, Arjun did not like to retaliate against his miscreant cousins and brothers, but it was the Lord's plan that they should all be killed. The devotee of the Lord does not retaliate against the wrongdoer, but the Lord does not tolerate any mischief done to the devotee by the miscreants. The Lord can excuse a person on his own account, but he excuses no one who has done harm to his devotees. Therefore, the Lord was determined to kill the miscreants, although Arjun wanted to excuse them. Thank you.